गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द केमिस्ट्री क्लास। टुडे आई स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज द पीरियोडिक टेबल। वी नो दैट इन आवर वर्ल्ड, ओके, 118 एलिमेंट्स आर देयर, एंड आउट ऑफ दीज 118 एलिमेंट्स 94 एलिमेंट्स आर नेचुरली ऑकरिंग। नाउ द मेथड ऑफ अरेंजिंग सिमिलर एलिमेंट्स टुगेदर एंड सेपरेटिंग देम फ्रॉम द डिसिमिलर एलिमेंट्स इज कॉल्ड द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट। एंड द एम ऑफ दिस क्लासिफिकेशन इज टू मेक द स्टडी ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स एंड देयर कंपाउंड्स इजियर। In the year 1860, chemists classified elements into two types. Okay, so first they classified elements into metals and non-metals. All of you know that metals have some metallic luster. Metals are very good conductor of heat and electricity. Metals are ductile, metals are malleable. If we beat metal, definitely there will be metallic sound. But elements which are easily brittle, that means easily breakable, and we cannot prepare a sheet, okay, that means they are not malleable or ductile, and they are bad conductor of heat and electricity, okay, and having no metallic luster, they are called non-metals. But some elements are there, later we have discovered, okay, that they have both the properties of the metals and non-metals, like arsenic, antimony, okay, they are called metalloids. So they are not in this group, that means this classification, metals and non-metals, okay, and that is why this classification rejected. Then another new scientist, okay, name was that Doebner, okay, in the year of 1817, he grouped the similar elements in triads like lithium, sodium, potassium. Okay, we can think about chlorine, bromine, iodine, and calcium, strontium, barium. Okay, so these elements, okay, are called triads. Okay, in each group there is three elements. Now, according to this Doebner law of triads, okay, in a triad of elements having similar properties, the atomic weight of the central atom was approximately the arithmetic mean of the atomic weights of the other two. Let us consider the first example in case of lithium, sodium and potassium. We know that lithium atomic mass is 7, potassium atomic mass is 39. Now if you do the average, that means 7 plus 39 divided by 2, what you will get? 9 plus 7, 6, 46 by 2, that is 23. So here the atomic number, all of you know that sodium is 23. Okay, so in this way, okay, this law is satisfied. Even in case of calcium, strontium, barium, calcium will be 40. Okay, this one calcium will be 40. And if you think about the atomic mass of barium, it will be around 137. Now if you take the average, it will come around 88.5. And strontium atomic mass is 88, so almost same, okay, or approximately same, okay. So these are the elements of the triad laws by Doebner, and this theory also rejected, as very few elements can be classified by this law, and in some cases there are some elements have nearly the same atomic mass. We know that calcium atomic mass 40, and argon also atomic mass 40. We know that cobalt atomic mass will be around 58.9 and nickel 58.7, almost same. So here this law will not work. Okay, and there was possibility, okay, to group dissimilar elements into the same triad. There may be dissimilar elements into the same triads. Okay, so that is why this law is rejected, and it is maximum. They have how many? Total 6 was there. 18 or 21 elements. Okay, are grouped in this triad table. Okay, that means Doebner's law, and that is why this law is rejected. Okay. Next, another new law came. This law is known as Newland's law of octaves. Okay, in the year of 1864, okay, that John Newland, okay, established one law, okay, to classify the elements. So according to this law, the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic weight, and the properties of the 8 succeeding element, where the repetition of the first one, like the 8th note of the musical scale. Okay, and the first and 8th elements were found, okay, to have similar properties. Okay, if we write the musical scale like sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, again this is coming, that sa. Okay, so here in the first period, that hydrogen, then what will come? That time to helium not discovered, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. Okay, this is the first. And second period here fluorine will come, fluorine, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur. And next we can write that third period. Okay, in third period it is coming that chlorine, potassium, calcium. After that calcium there is chromium, then titanium, then manganese, then iron. Okay, but this law, okay, worked well for the lighter elements. Here atomic weight was recognized as the basis of the classification, and this law also rejected. Okay, because with the discovery of rare gases, that means helium, neon, argon, krypton, okay, xenon, radon, okay, so then next another group is required. So this music note will not work here. Okay, and not the eighth, okay, having the similar chemical properties. Okay, when the helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, if you will consider, that will not work here. And this law is applicable up to the calcium. Okay, up to the calcium it is okay. After that there is some anomalous behavior. Okay, that is not matching. In this law, iron is placed where? With sulfur in the same group. Okay, but their properties are different. In this law, manganese and phosphorus are in the same group. So their properties are different. Okay, so definitely this is not okay. That means they are up to calcium, it is okay. Okay, and this classification did not work for heavier element also. That is why this law also rejected. Next, Mendeleev's periodic table come. Okay, Mendeleev's periodic table, this is very important. And the first successful periodic table was given by Sir Dmitri Mendeleev in the year of 1869, and he was a Russian chemist. Okay, and that time total number of element was 63 elements. Okay, and he arranged the elements according to their increasing mass number, and he observed that elements with the similar properties occur at the regular intervals. Okay, and it is called he called this as the periodicity of the properties of elements. Next, based on this, he proposed a law called Mendeleev's periodic law. According to this law, the physical and chemical properties of the elements are periodic function of their atomic masses. Okay, and next we will discuss that this periodic table, there are vertical columns, okay, they are called groups, and there are horizontal rows, okay, they are called periods. And in Mendeleev's periodic table, there are 8 groups, okay, and from 1 to 8, that means we are writing in the Roman letter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 8. So these are elements are kept in the particle, okay, particle place. So these are called groups, and that time the number of periods was, I think it will be 6, okay, and each group, that up to 7, is divided into 2 subgroups. One is called A, another is called B. So up to 7, A, B, A, B, A, B, A, B, in this way. But at the 8, okay, that means group 8 consists of the 3 vertical columns, and each one containing the 3 elements. Okay, and next day I'll draw this Mendeleev periodic table in board, okay, then you can easily understand. And in a period, elements gradually change, okay, from metallic to non-metallic. That means when we are going from left to right in a period, then metallic character decreases and non-metallic character increases, okay. And today up to this, and next day we shall discuss more about the Mendeleev's periodic table, as well as the merits and demerits of this periodic table. Actually, this periodic table also not correct. It was modified by Moseley and Niels Bohr, and now there is modern periodic table. And in this modern periodic table, elements are arranged according to their electronic configuration, or you can say their atomic number. Okay, so this is your last chapter in your Half Yearly exam, and other 4 chapters we have completed. If you have any type of question, okay, that you can easily ask in the live class, okay, as well as you can send your SMS through me WhatsApp, and another option is there, that is through your school query button you can send me questions, okay. And exercise solutions I will give you some here, I will discuss when I will get time, okay, after completion of your syllabus, okay, that means half yearly syllabus. And today up to this, thank you.